Ladies and gentlemen, and graduates of the 2015 class of Electrical Engineering, welcome to graduation. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. As we start the event, I would now like to invite the Electrical Engineering faculty and our graduation speaker to proceed to the stage. Please be seated. I would like to invite our department chair, Dr. Radha Puvendran, to the stage.
Welcome to our annual Electrical Engineering graduation celebration. We are delighted to have you here tonight. I would like also to acknowledge the guests in the room next door. We are grateful that you are able to join us here for tonight's ceremony. We gather here together to honor our graduate students who have worked hard during their time here in UWEE. We have an especially outstanding group of graduates this year. This is the largest number of graduate students or graduating students group since 2001. It has been a pleasure for our faculty to work with each and every student. The enthusiasm, energy, intelligence, and creativity of our graduate students is unparalleled. I would like now to introduce the faculty joining us tonight. Please stand briefly when your name is announced. Professor Payman Arab-Sahi. Professor Jeff Bilmes. Professor Linda Bushnell. Professor Howard Chisek. Professor Rich Christie. Professor Tom Swick. And congratulations to his son, who is graduating. Professor Bruce Darling. Professor Scott Dunham. Professor Michael Hochberg. Professor Vikram Jandiala. Professor Daniel Kirshen. Professor Tadayoshi Kono. Professor Mari Ostendorf. Professor James Peckel. Professor Eve Riskin. Professor Francisca Rosner. Professor Chris Rudell. Professor John Sarf. Professor Richard Shee. Professor Joshua Smith. Professor Mani Soma. Professor Lung Zhang. Professor Dennis Wilson. Professor Baozhen Zhang. I would now like to tell you a little bit about our department and the accomplishments in the recent past, which makes it an excellent place. As the new department chair, I am particularly fortunate to meet with many alumni who have gone on remarkable careers and achievements in their lives. Our e-graduates today are poised to continue this legacy. They have a truly bright future ahead of them. As our alumni confirm, an electrical engineering degree is one of the best engineering degrees available, allowing our students to choose almost any career that demands technical innovation and creativity. Our students graduate from a first-class electrical engineering program at the top-ranked university with a degree in one of the highest demand career fields. They should be proud of their admission into the extremely competitive program and for completing a challenging program. On the way, many have gained valuable research and internship experiences that will lead to graduate school, rewarding positions in industry or in research institutions. I am delighted to say that when meeting with alumni, industry and people at other academic institutions, UWEE is exceptionally well cited and respected for our achievements. We are thrilled to continue the tradition of hiring excellent junior faculty in the recent years. This year, we were excited to welcome three new faculty members, Arka Majumdar, Sriram Kannan, and Baozhen Zhang. This year, we also hired an exceptionally high-quality junior faculty member, Lillian Radliff, who receives her PhD from University of California at Berkeley. I'm delighted that the tradition of high quality and high energy faculty interacting with our students will continue well into the future. Our faculty members are at the forefront of innovation, something we do well at UWEE. But at the foundation are our students. In 2014, our department reported 49 innovations. Of a record 18 startups that launched campus-wide last year, 4 were from the UWEE department. An excellent example of technical skill set combined with entrepreneurial is Mr. Ben Waters, who is graduating from this batch with a PhD. He founded Vibotics, a wireless power system company for robotics. He is going to be running the company as he graduates. I am very proud of this department. It's a privilege for me to chair this department. Now, it's my great pleasure to introduce the graduation ceremony speaker, Dr. Stuart Wu, who received his master's degree in electrical engineering in 1985 and his PhD in electrical engineering in 1990, both from our department. In addition to being a serial entrepreneur, Stuart is also a member of the UWEE Advisory Board, shaping the future of our department. I would like to extend a warm welcome to Stuart and his family. I'm grateful that you can join us tonight. Accompanying Stuart to Seattle from his home in San Jose are his wife Teresa, son Calvin, and the youngest son Michael. Stuart's older son Calvin is also a UWEE alum, and he has a minor in microbiology from UW as well, and he is pursuing his MBA at present. Those who know Stuart know him as a highly charismatic and hardworking individual who is generous with his time and commitment to service. Stuart grew up in Taiwan, where he earned his bachelor's degree. He was exposed to engineering from an early age. His father was an engineer who studied both civil and mechanical engineering. Stuart is currently a vice president of Cortina Systems, which was acquired by Strom Semiconductors in 2008. Stuart founded Strom Semiconductors in 2002. His vision was to revolutionize the home networking infrastructure with an initial focus on addressing networking and storage space together. This initiative brought to the market the first dual-core embedded network processor, which is now widely accepted and designed into many consumer and small to medium-sized businesses. Prior to founding Strom Semiconductor, Stuart was a general manager at Broadcom, where he helped spearhead the development of Greater China area. As a result of his efforts, the revenue in China increased from tens of millions to hundreds of millions. Before joining Broadcom, Stuart was a chairman, founder, president, and CEO of Ultima Communications Incorporated, which was acquired by Broadcom in July 2000. When it reached an annual revenue of more than $40 million within 3 years. Stuart founded Ultima in 1997, focusing on a wide variety of networking ICs. As you can see, we are extremely proud of our alum Stuart. He's an excellent example of serial entrepreneurship founded on technology. Please join me welcoming our very own Dr. Stuart Wu.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, the anxious graduate to be.
Oh, sorry, I think I need to turn it off here.
Hello, it's echoing. It's with my greatest pleasure to be standing here to give you my humble opinion. And you know, it's just about.
Some technical difficulty.
Is it good?
Okay. As last time I was invited here, I need to pay for my tuition. And this time, as you can see, as the chairman just introduced, as a non-native English speaking person standing here, I have to be with tremendous courage and the value to come to forward you my word to the young graduate engineer like you are. And as you can see that UW has presented me a lot of value to give me who I am today. Now it's actually giving to my second generation, my son Calvin, who is also a strong Husky. So I'm the past, Now let's move on to the current. And every time I come back, I really feel blessing, see the, how the department has been involved through the year. And with all the face, new faces and old faces, I really feel blessed I'm part of this UW family. And now moving on to, you know, what's our topic today. As you know that for the introduction, I'm really an entrepreneur. So my today's topic will be focused on entrepreneurship, but how to transform your life. Sorry, it's not easy when you speak to so many people in this podium. Okay. And so from first point I really want to give you is the what is the definition of entrepreneurship? Okay, many people ask me. In my view, entrepreneurship is how you aggressively pursuing opportunity. Not just getting a 9-to-5 paying job or just running a business. This is the first point I really want you to remember. And the second point I really want you to remember is what is different between gift the gift and choices. Cleverness is gift. Hardworking is choices. Gift is coming from the God. You can say coming from the chances. But hardworking is something you choose to do. Okay. But if you choose to let the gift to run wild, it may become a detriment to your career or to your life. Many times, you know, we always said, no pain, no gain. It is true. In my belief, I strongly believe that hardworking is the only way for you to gain something. If you really think about how 30 years ago, when I first come to University of Washington, I was very frightened, timid, and I don't really know where I will be. You never know that, I don't even know whether I even deserve a PhD. I don't think I'm gifted. I don't think I'm genius. All I believe is one thing. I set up my goal and execute on it. I said, then I might have a chance to become successful. To reiterate, allow me to give you some of my past history when I first come to Seattle. Seattle to me is like a second hometown. When I first fly out from here, that was the first time I really take a flight. Okay, so I don't really know how to buckle up. And when people say buckle up, I say, why I need to buckle my button or something? And how can you imagine? In less than 13, 14 years later, I become a major VIP for a major airline. That means I fly a lot now. And also, UW to me is, in a way, it's a destiny. You know, when I first walk into UW, I see many people have my last name in front because UW's reverse is WU. Okay, then I say, I found my destiny school. Okay? What's funny is, and I took my first class with Mr. Lytle. I think a lot of people probably still have a Lytle lecture series. It was a hard lesson. I was horrified. I could barely understand what he was talking about. You know, and I see everybody raising his hand left and right, you know, trying to, having a very engaging conversation. I said, oh my boy, I must be, what kind of grade am I going to have? So all I have, this kind of paranoia drive me to study day in and day out. We just, at the time, we just have so-called televised program. So we have starting to have videotape. I was the one always going to the library, just borrowing the tape, reviewing, you know, trying to understand every word Professor Lytle was talking about. Guess what? And I got mostly 4.0 in most of my classes. Okay? So that's called hard work. However, you must say that if you work so hard, you're never going to have any fail story. I have a lot of fail story. Okay, the first fail story is like I was entering the PhD qualifying exam. Unfortunately, I failed. The fail was so hard as you come out as a foreign kid, you know, which you have no turning back. All you think about is a study. I really felt my life is worthless. Okay. I don't want to mention the detail because my wife knows the detail, which was very suffering. And then here comes, fast forward, the second failure was the second qualifying exam. Boy, you see, my PhD is very hard to get. And, you know, actually the second one turned out to be a life-changing one for me because I was flunked by my original advisor, which I don't want to name his name. And I was picked up by my current lifelong advisor, Professor Hong, which is sitting in this podium by me. Okay. The reason it's life-changing for me is because he renewed my interest, I mean, my belief about I can really do graduate study. At the same time, he really brought me back to where I belong to, you know, the mixed signal design, the so-called black magic. And through the year, even though a lot of times, you know, people say, Professor Hong, you really not caring so much of the detail, but I really learned a lot of lifelong lessons from him. That's how your advisor will give you, I think most of you experience. And because of that lifelong lesson, I'll give you one example. He always told me, hey, you know, Stuart, if you want to, aim at the missile, if you aim at your shooting, you will never get it. You always want to predetermine an estimate before you shoot it. You know what this is called today? This is called marketing. This is called how you predicting the people is doing, and then you do your work. If you see and you shoot, that means reacting to the market. Okay. So what I did, all this thing combined, I spent my PhD thesis. Within 2 years after I graduated, that's how I sold a $500 million company, okay, to a major company in the world. Okay. So this is some lifelong lesson which I really owe a lot to the Professor Helm and also to this department. As you can see, how this department can really bring the best of me, even I'm at the most hopeless moment. And so in this one, I want to want you to remember the last point I really want to give you. It's hard to fail, but it's worse never been trying to succeed. And many of you, most of the people ask me, where's the opportunity? How did you find yours? I want to quote this famous person called Jack Ma, Alibaba, okay, which I'm translating in Chinese. He say, when people see trap or pothole, you should focus on the path along the pothole because that's where you got the best opportunity to become successful. Okay. So it's only when you focus, the opportunity will come. Opportunity actually come will be unexpected. The winner is always part of a solution. The loser is always part of an excuse. The winner is always trying to know, how to solve things. The loser will always try to find why I'm a failure. And two of the funny experiences I had in my past, I want to share with you, that kind of tell you that opportunities are everywhere, you just don't know it. Back in, before Y2K, internet boom is still not yet there. One of my close friends, who is also my neighbor, was very successful and had a company, had the office suite, wanted to get rented out. And one day he told me that there are a whole bunch of young kids come to him. Hey, I want to rent your office suite. You know, why don't you rent it to me? But I really don't have money. Okay. Can I exchange equity for you for the rent? And my friend say, he kind of joked to me, you know, all these youngsters, they must be insane. They think equity is worth so much. And they have, plus they have such a funny company name. It's called Yahoo. So my friend pounding his head all the rest of his life. And then fast forward, maybe about 5 years later, I had the opportunity to share a Mountain View office with another startup, which we share a small bathroom. You know, I'm pretty big. This guy also pretty big. So you see two big guys, you know, kind of like squeezing each other. So when you squeeze each other, you kind of want to, you talk, right? Because there's smell also. And you're kind of like, what do? In your business, because your business is kind of like a combination. The business is the combination of a word. You know, it's not really a noun or verb or anything. It's funny. It's called linking. LinkedIn today is a $40 billion company, which was founded today. I mean, together when, you know, with me. So the guy who shared the bathroom with me all the time was actually the later billionaire, Ray Hoffman. So, as you can see that opportunity always comes to you. I always want to use an analogy. Earthquake, when earthquake occur, before that you won't know it. You only know afterward. Okay? So opportunity is always there. But you need to prepare for it. You need to make the best of you and prepare for the opportunity. Otherwise, you know, just like before the earthquake, you need to do some preparation. Earthquake, you know, save, you know, everything. You save the water, save everything. You need to prepare for it. Then you can become successful. And also, just like, you know, nowadays, my son and we are very into the NBA basketball, you know, because of Golden State Warrior, because we are Warrior fan, just keep on winning the streak. So I want to use one of the quotes coming out from this MVP, even though he's very young, but I think he's very talented. So the so-called that, you know, you need to be the best version of your life. Do not leave other people's story. And also, just like, you know, the late Steve Jobs used to say, even though he says stay hungry, stay foolish, everybody, you know, heard about this. But I think one thing he also brings out in the message is that you need to try to find what you love for you to work. You only when you find your interest, you will do a great work. Okay? And if you haven't found it, you just need to keep on finding it and don't settle with it. And in my life, my belief is that when you have a passion, the passion will spark opportunity. When you have opportunity, what is opportunity? Opportunity is the cornerstone for the entrepreneurship. Okay. Once you have a grand plan for your life, and you don't be distracted by the life, all this trap, all this pothole, you focus on grand plan, for sure you will have some success. You can rest for sure one day you'll be like me, old, ugly, highly paid, and less mobile. And compared with those young, smart, and beautiful, and less pay, and how can I compete? It's your passion, it's your interest to drive your world wealth of experience and the knowledge to build the entry barrier against them to take on your position. Finally, I'd like to, again, congratulate for all the class of 2015. And congratulations for all the family member. And this is the regular thing I need to say. Family member and friends to support it. You need to go back to them tonight to really thank them for their support. It takes a lot of courage. And may you live all this Husky spirit for the rest of your life. Go Husky.
Thank you, Stuart.
Thank you
for sharing your insightful thoughts and also sharing your personal experience.
Yes, thank you.
I think youth is beautiful because that's where you don't worry about the risks and you take the risks. You'll follow your path. Now, in appreciation of your presenting your thoughts, we also want to present a small gift to you.
Thank you.
This reads from the department, in recognition of your inspiring the next generation of engineers, Dr. Stuart Wu, graduation speaker 2015.
That's good. Okay. Thank you.
And it goes with a formal certificate as well, in case you don't want to carry the crystal around.
Yeah, I don't want it. I don't want to break it.
Yes.
I'm old and clumsy, you know.
So this is the formal certificate.
Okay.
Which again says...
that looks very, very nice. Thank you, appreciate it. Hey, you know... Wait, there's a two certificate. Maybe this one is for another Husky?
Yeah, everybody, every Husky. I think I made a mistake.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Let me read it for. It reads 40 years of excellence. UW Department of Electrical Engineering is hereby awarded on June 12, 2015 to Warhelm in celebration of dedication and service from 1964 to 2004.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you should hold it together.
Thank you. Sorry to make a little turn. Today is also my advisor's birthday.
Yeah. Happy birthday. So, Professor Stuart Wu was also our graduate student. He finished his PhD and decided that he loved the University of Washington quite a bit. So under the apprentice of Professor Irene Peden, he joined here in 1964 and dedicated his initial research for Antarctic fun, and then on the way he stopped to New Zealand and found his wife. That I think that's a real part of the research.
All right.
And then he came back and continued mentoring a lot of students and inspired many of the students and was dedicated to this department for 40 years. So we are very glad that he is here, and thank you very much from our department on behalf of our department. And happy birthday as well.
Good. This is a present for you. Oh. This is another destiny for me.
So this is a crystal for you, which says 40 years of excellence in celebration to dedication and service to 1964 to 2004, okay. University of Washington Electrical Engineering Department. We thank you very much for having dedicated your life for our department. It means a lot to me, and it means a lot to our faculty. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
One for Stuart.
So So what maybe should I put on the side? Maybe I'll put it on the side.
So as you can see, Teresa is saying,
it's okay. I'm not used to it.
Stuart told me that his wife is everything and she is the center of life.
Yeah.
So I see that.
You need to have happy life, happy wife, happy family.
So as we move on, the next important thing is to recognize those faculty, staff, and students who not only do their excellent work in what their descriptions of why they are here, but also their dedication to excellence and setting example to this department. So we are moving into recognition of awards recipients. So I will present each of your name, and then Dr. Stuart Wu will hand you over your certificates. So the first award is the Outstanding Staff Award. This year we have two recipients for our Outstanding Staff Award, Lindsay Appesland and Bill Lyons. So Bill is unable to join us today, so Lindsay is accepting Bill's award on his behalf.
Put this away.
You can, yes. So you can this. The Outstanding Staff Award recognizes staff members who have consistently exceeded expectations. Lindsay demonstrates an exceptional talent for organizing our events and managing logistics. She is skilled at collaborating with faculty and staff to make an event even interesting or outstanding. Bill is a treasure trove of creative approaches and strategies when it comes to providing students with excellent lab experience. He also shows admirable concern for students and their quality of education. The next award is the Outstanding Faculty Award. This year's Outstanding Faculty Award goes to Georg Seelig. Georg is unable to attend tonight, so Professor Mario Ostendorf will be accepting the award on his behalf. You can take the photo if you want together.
Okay. Oh. Huh?
The Outstanding Faculty Award recognizes a faculty member who demonstrates a clear commitment to the students and the department. Georg stood out this year as an innovative researcher who is open and collaborative. He is an instructor dedicated to enhancing the curriculum by introducing novel material at the graduate level. He also mentors students through UW College of Engineering Bridge Program. The next award is Outstanding Undergraduate Student Award. This year's Outstanding Undergraduate Award goes to Zarina Kapetanovic. I guess so she is here. The Outstanding Undergraduate Student recognizes an undergraduate student who shows exemplary commitment to the department in service activities. Zarina is in two honor societies, has been both a TA, teaching assistant, and a research assistant, and is a research mentor to high school students. An undergraduate researcher, she presented a paper at the 2015 IEEE Radio Frequency Identification Conference. This smells like Professor Josh Smith. Okay, the next one is Outstanding Professional Student Award. This year's Outstanding Professional Student Award goes to Chelsea Olsen. Chelsea, please come up. Yeah. The Outstanding Professional Student Award is in recognition of a professional student who shows an exemplary commitment to their education and career. Chelsea joined Boeing as a flight test engineer after her graduation from UWEE and quickly advanced to a top secret design work. She is also on the board of Washington Aerospace Scholars and is involved in Amelia's Aero Club, which provides mentoring for young girls in science. Maybe you will connect with Professor Eve Riskin, who is our Dean of Diversity. The next award goes to, next award is Yang Research Award for Outstanding Doctoral Student. This year's Yang Research Award for Outstanding Doctoral Student goes to Tamara Bonacci. Tamara, please come up. The Yang Research Award for Outstanding Doctoral Student is in recognition of a doctoral student who has conducted outstanding research in the field of electrical engineering. Tamara's research is highly innovative, and she has received numerous awards and contributed to 3 filed patents to date. Her research expertise includes mathematics and algorithms development for security and privacy of cyber-physical systems, legal and ethical issues related to these fields. I personally know Tamara has worked with Yoshi Kono, professor from computer science, and Ryan Carlo, professor from law school, and she is mentored by Professor Howard Chisek. The next award is Vikram Jantiala and Suja Vaidyanathan Endowed Innovation Award in Electrical Engineering. Vikram said Suja was going to be late. Oh, she's there. Okay, he didn't say that. Vikram is our former department chair, and he was keen on making the change what we are seeing today. He was instrumental in changing how the department is moving forward. I have worked with him as a chair of the faculty search for 2 years, and it was a wonderful experience. He lets people do the right thing for the department. And so this award is jointly established by Suja and Vikram. I think that is the right order, but we always give the name to our faculty first. Have founded an Endowed Innovation Award to recognize students with an entrepreneurial spirit. Vikram now serves as a Vice Provost for Innovation for Commotion, which provides mentoring and resources for UW innovators to help them take their innovation to the market. We are fortunate to have Vikram and Suja in the audience today. Thank you both for your generosity to the department. Thank you, Vikram. This Innovation Award is open to both undergraduate and graduate students, so they established 2 awards. This year we had 1 nomination, and this is an excellent example of a student who is busy with their courses, research, and all other demands, and still have the excitement to create a company even before they graduate and get out of the University of Washington with a formal degree. This year's award goes to Rahil Jain. Rahil, please come up, and I'm going to ask Vikram to join us in jointly giving, because it's a great opportunity for us to have a donor who is part of this award. Rahil, where are you? There he is. Yeah, Suja, yes. Maybe I should have asked Suja to join.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Rahil is a founder of Hook, a home automation hub that allows customers to convert existing home devices to smart gadgets, which decreases energy consumption. Hook recently received 10,000 second place prize at the Alaska Airlines Environmental Innovation Challenge at the UW. So So that concludes our awards presentation. And once again, let's thank all the award winners. So as we move on to present the graduate students, I request that you all be seated in your place. It's an exciting moment for everyone, but we will read the names and each of them will cross the podium, and you will have an opportunity later to take all the photos. But right now you will be seated and enjoy the moment. So the first is the presentation of PhD graduates. I am pleased to introduce Dr. Eve Riskin, Associate Dean of Diversity and Access, who together with Bruce Darling, who is Associate Chair for Education, will announce the name of our PhD graduates. And before the presentation, Professor Bruce Darling will also give a short presentation.
Good evening and welcome. The Doctor of Philosophy is the highest degree granted by our department and the highest degree recognized by the profession. It not only affirms a mastery of the specialty area, but it also demonstrates the successful completion of independent research, which has led to new knowledge, new understanding, or new technique. Pushing these limits is what propels technological innovation and what allows the research of today to become the practice of the future. Our PhD graduates are our treasured investment in tomorrow, and we look to them to provide the leadership and expertise to solve the most difficult and pressing problems of the world. Additionally, the hard work over many years of study creates a special relationship between each PhD student and their faculty advisor. Inspiration, contemplation, perspiration, success is mixed between some failures, but finally leading to shared achievement, satisfaction, and purpose. That's fundamentally what the degree is about. While the degree itself is bestowed upon one, the pathway to that degree involves many, most pivotal being the student's advisor. The role of student and mentor is a very special collegial relationship which will last a lifetime. To acknowledge that relationship and the achievement of the Doctor of Philosophy degree, we should now announce the 2015 PhD graduates in electrical engineering who will each be hooded by their faculty advisors. First, Timothy Morrison, who will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Brian Otis.
Chu Cheng Yang will be hooded by his PhD advisor, our chair, Radha Puvindran. Forgot to mention he's going to go work for Disney. So.
Yu Young, who will be hooded by his PhD advisor is Professor Sumit Roy, and he will be hooded by Professor Radha Puvindran.
Men-Che Zhuang worked with Zheneng Wang, who is not here today, so Professor Mari Ostendorf will hood him, and he is planning to work in EE-related industry.
Mm-hmm. Matthew Akio Strasinski. He will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Michael Hochberg.
Alex Marin will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Mari Ostendorf, and he's working in research at Microsoft.
Nicole Nichols, she'll be hooded by her PhD advisor, Professor Mari Ostendorf.
Tamara Bonacci will be hooded by her PhD advisor, Howard Chizik.
Rishab Iyer will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Jeff Bilmes.
Tian Hao Liao will be hooded by his advisor, Lang Tsang, and he's heading into research.
Temitakpe Oluwafemi will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Tayoshi Kono, and Franzi Reusner.
Okay. Yuan Chui Chen worked with Professor Georg Seelig. Since he's not here, he is going to be hooded by Professor Howard Chizik.
Farzad Hesar, his PhD advisor is Professor Sumit Roy, and he'll be hooded by Professor Radha Bhuvendran in his absence.
Xiaowu Wang will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Lang Sang, and he's working in research at Intel.
Mohammed Abu Hussein will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Richard Christie.
Benjamin Waters will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Josh Smith, and he'll be working at Wybotic Incorporated. Okay.
Kanan Sankar Gomati will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Brian Otis.
Manohar Nagaraju will be hooded by his PhD advisor, Professor Brian Otis, and he's working at Cisco Systems.
Andrew Clark. He's being advised by both Professor Radha Pubendran and Linda Bushnell, and he will be hooded by Professor Pubendran.
Almaz Nagesh will be hooded by her PhD advisor, Daniel Kirshen, and she's deciding, but she's got a couple offers, good offers here.
Yes, so now I introduce Professor Josh Smith. He is the director of the Professional Masters Program Coordinator, and he's going to say a few words. But before he says, he's a joint hire between the Computer Science Department and Electrical Engineering Department. So when he was hired, they asked what I described in short. I said, creativity unlimited. And Brent Waters is his student, Vibotics startup, and he has three startups. And this is the future of where our students are going.
Putting you under extreme pressure here. Oh, this is working well. Okay. So in the ancient universities of Britain, when they did not have microphones, the master's degree was a ceremonial one that required no extra work beyond the bachelor's degree, and yet conferred extraordinary privileges, such as the right to walk on reserved patches of college grass, to dine at high table, and even to vote for an extra representative in the nation's parliament. The 66 master's degrees being conferred today provide none of those privileges. But they are far from ceremonial. Each of the 25 daytime and 41 professional master's degrees we are about to award represents years of work and study, financial sacrifice, and time away from families during evenings, particularly for the professional master's students. The learning that the master's degrees represent is an end in itself. And while the degree no longer confers additional voting rights, it does lead to increased career opportunity and responsibility. We will now admit the 2015 candidates to the MSEE degree.
Agustina Gonzalez.
Jesus Contreras Ocaña.
Aaron Turgay.
Justin Palm.
Morgan Dacey,
Mohammed Abu Omar,
Mohammed Hassanin,
Basim Al Humaili,
Douglas Dominguez,
Mohammed El Zarif,
Hoang Pham,
Anil Ganti,
Brian Howard,
Patrick Sills,
Chelsea Olson,
Alan Engelhart,
Cody Hogan,
Tyler Mansfield,
Rebecca Briding,
Priyanka Chandra Balun,
Heng Chen,
Kevin Axman,
Sarah Bossom,
Minqing Huang,
Chiang Yu,
Zhuzhen Zhu,
Meng Lin Li,
Wenyang Lau,
okay. Edwin Presidio,
Benjamin Chisdell,
Abdul Alhamidi,
Elizabeth Sanmarti Robla,
Elmin Elaya,
Mohammed Tahir Rahman,
Daniel Micheletti,
Eric Pepin,
Nathan Bielke,
George Jonas,
switching to undergraduate degree program, MSEE. Dr. Jim Peckel, our undergraduate program coordinator, will now say a few words before presentation. Jim.
Again, good evening. Welcome, everyone. I'd like to join my colleagues here tonight in congratulating each and every one of our graduates and recognizing the hard work and the long hours that you've put in to be able to be here tonight. I'd also like to extend a welcome to each and every one of you as colleagues. Tonight, yes, you now are the engineers. All of the parents, relatives, and friends, thank each and every one of you for all of the years of work in helping and guiding and enabling them to be here tonight. For each of our new engineers, as you walk across this stage tonight, I strongly encourage you to take the words of Robert Frost with you. He reflected, two roads diverged in a woods. Sorry, I could not travel both. I took the one less traveled, and that made all the difference. As you walk tonight, reach out, challenge, explore, ask why, ask what if. Take the less traveled path. Imagine where that might lead you. Our forebears gave us the rivers, the oceans, mountains, and continents. We gave you the moon, Mars, and beyond. I challenge each of you here tonight and ask, what will you leave for the next generation? Thank you all very much and all the best to you. Congratulations.
We'll begin announcing the bachelor's candidates. First, Jindi Liu.
Yushan Chen.
Ki Yan.
Lin Kong Lee.
Yusuf Robel.
Mustafa Inamami.
Muhammad Osama.
Burgess Malarkey.
Sam Delano.
Timothy Pollard.
Vincentius Utano.
Valerie Fardelli.
Yeti Luo.
Zarina Kapitanovic.
Ping Chu.
Brandon Johansson.
It's just in my mouth.
Thomas Appleseth.
Alex Huang.
Jared Osterley.
Janelle Liebel.
Catherine Yamada.
Yashua Nan.
Jun Yao.
Deanna Mohagi.
Ching Yap.
Catherine Feng.
Congratulations. Jingyi Yang.
Nicholas Morello.
Connor Thomas.
Not Kun Lee. Not Kun Lai, sorry.
Jeffrey Alcock.
Ryan McGinty.
Bilkit Gathinji.
Jacob Dunn.
Scott Jurdy.
Han Yi.
Wenjuan Wu.
Corey Kyerlaber.
James Spencer.
Nicholas Denny.
Rody Lundquist.
Nick Pfeiffer.
Kyle Martin.
Stephen Bailey.
Philip Crawford.
Taylor Vander Clay.
Tian Liang Lee.
Junti Zeng.
Meng Shu.
Alex Lindell.
Charles Lane.
Brandon Asham.
Joshua Najedli.
Thor Winters.
Thomas Way.
Connor Ballou.
Shane Coburn.
Vance Horia.
Bayou Halim.
Brian York.
Oleg Kazimierz.
Pavel Derluk.
Brittany Jolly.
Shin Ten.
Yanbo Zhu.
Samuel Kaylee.
Joshua Luo.
Henry O'Brien.
Benjamin Sukas.
Fang Kuen Fu.
Sanghoon Han.
Brian Ofter Springer.
Ryan Cox.
Kira Torkildsen.
Anna Brokhaug.
Ivana Se.
Sun Pham.
Jasmine Singh.
Hamilton Sanchez.
Sung Kim.
Bin Yu.
Alex Chittim.
Robert Peterson.
Alexander Hovsepian.
Trung Lu.
Anton Swick.
Joanna Hamilton.
Chao Gao.
Jin Dang.
Ning Yang.
Nan Jiang.
Xu Dong.
Daniel Zhang.
Debo Smith Ray.
Youngjin Koei.
Hua Win.
Su Tong Lam.
Ka An Win.
Hui Lei.
Ki Tu.
Rebecca Kim.
Yeah. Joshua Vadim. Yeah.
Jay Feng.
Zenin Lee.
Boling Yang.
Bohen Wang.
Kyle Lindgren.
Sen Mao.
Joshua Yip.
Ruhi Span.
Spiro Delani.
Raquel Joko.
William Huang.
Joel Atienza.
Ziming Lee.
Chen Yao.
Chikai Tan.
Sean Lin Zhu.
Chung Lin.
Si Chao Chen.
Chiyoung Fung.
Bowen Shue.
Eason Sademogadam.
Nita Hosini.
Rehian Wang.
Mark Mata Bhaghi.
Kaiming Si.
Samuel Oreda.
Michael Mez.
Dibebe Ishte.
Nadia Kazi.
Guangyi Liu.
Patrick Howe.
Chen Shen Yuan.
Kathy Oyun.
Kendrick Tang.
And finally, Christopher Engelbrecht.
So first, I'd like to thank Professor Bruce Darling and Professor Eve Riskin for presenting all the names continuously. Thank you very much. So please join me in congratulating the bachelor's, master's, and the PhD graduates of 2015. Now, this is to the graduates. Please stand up and join me in thanking your family, friends, and your teachers and mentors. You can be seated again. So I would like to take this moment to also thank the UWEE advising staff who work with our students, undergraduate level, masters, and the graduate level, helping them to, swim through, maneuver, mitigate, and finally successfully defend your respective degrees. I'd like to mention the names explicitly for the work they do. This is Brian Crockett, Academic Services Director. Brenda Larson,
graduate counselor. You may stand up when your name is called. And Stephanie Swanson. Erin Allnon. Catherine Sykes. Stephen Graham. I'd also like to thank our events team, Pam Eisenheim, Lindsay Appeslan, and then finally, I would like to thank the former department chairs who paved the way for the department to be where it is, Professor Howard Chisek, Professor Lung Zhang, Professor Vikram Jantela, and then Professor John Sark, and Professor Bruce Darling. In closing, I would like to thank or acknowledge one faculty member who chose to sit with his family. Tom Swick, you can stand up. So thank you all for celebrating this significant milestone with us tonight. This event is closed at this point. Thank you.